Hello and welcome to Talking Tech. My name is Alejandro Hoyos, and today our guest is Daniel Benatar, Corporate VP, Co-General Manager, Worldwide Semiconductor Manufacturing. Thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. We're visiting Israel. We have the pleasure to be visiting Israel today. And I wanted to ask you to tell us a little bit more about yourself.
Thank you. My role is Co-General Manager of Worldwide Semiconductor Manufacturing. We are running the entire semiconductor manufacturing in the world for Intel. And I'm very proud of it. I'm like 30 years within Intel. I did manufacturing. I was in a development site a few years in Portland, Oregon, and returned back to Israel.
Oh, that's great. So your beginnings with in the factory in Portland. So
I started actually in Jerusalem.
Oh, in Jerusalem?
In Jerusalem.
Wow. That's great. And then you moved to Portland and then came back. How long were you in Jerusalem? How long were you in Portland?
I was in Jerusalem for, I joined Intel in 93. Mm-hmm. So I've been there like 7 years. And then I moved to Portland for another 4 or 5 years. I was in the development center. And then I moved to do the first 300 millimeters factories in New Mexico, Albuquerque, New Mexico. And then I returned back to Israel. I returned back to Israel in 2006. And since then, I'm here in Kiryat Gat,
south of Israel. So with that said, tell us a little bit more about your vision about IDM 2.0. Where you think Intel is going with that? Where you see the future for us there?
I think our vision is that, first of all, we want to bring the gold back home. When I'm saying bring the gold back home, I'm talking about to be number one in the entire world for any parameters, operational parameters that Intel is doing at manufacturing, everything. We want to have the best safety and performance in the world, to have the people, you know, to develop them, that they will have a meaningful assignment, that they will bring themselves every shift, every day to work and to contribute to Intel. And then the operational parameters, it's like quality, the dial, the line yield, velocity of the line, how fast you run these microprocessors into the line, and then to make it in a costly manner. So we found the best wafer cost in the world.
So in order to accomplish that, tell us a bit more of the different factories being built across the world, right? Just to be able to achieve that.
So we have, this is the first time that this kind of things happened at Intel. And I'm personally very excited. This is something that new to me. If at the past, you know, we did not build, now we are building new factories. We are building one in Arizona, the Eagle. Yep. We call it like, this is our birds, by the way. Eagle in Arizona.
So bird names?
Bird name, bird name. Eagle in Arizona. We have the Cardinal in Ohio. Mm-hmm. We have the Blue Jay in Ireland. We have the Oil in Germany. And we have the Sparrow here in Israel.
Nice, yes. Yeah, all of them, you recently break ground for them. So they're going on right now.
Absolutely.
No, that's great. And here in Israel, you're currently, you have a manufacturing here. I have Fab 28. What family products are you currently producing here?
Here, I'm very proud of the factory managers, Karen, Merav, and Oren. They're producing the super thin 10 nanometers mm-hmm. and Intel 7. Like you probably heard about the products like Alder Lake.
Yes, correct.
Now Raptor Lake, we are going to talk about them the entire week.
Yep, that's great. So here we have Alder Lake, so which is the 12th generation processors, and we have Raptor Lake, which will be the future will be the 13th generation. So no, that's pretty amazing. But tell us a little bit more about the challenges that you were able to overcome and together to hit this amazing goal, so ramping up so quickly.
In our world, in order to ramp very fast, safely and very fast in high quality manner to produce those microprocessors fast to our customers in high quality manner, you need to generate a detailed plan for one factory. Mm-hmm. And then this detailed plan, you all the time need to learn how to improve it and take it to another fab. And another fab is adopt this plan and improve it and take it the same to another fab. And by that, you have a plan, you start with a plan, but you all the time adopt it on the new fab. And by that, it allows you to ramp very fast any fab. So you all the time, you have a detailed plan, improve the plan, implement it, improve the plan, implement, improve the plan, implement, and executing with a lot of discipline. Discipline, it's a good word for us. It's something that says we have a detailed plan and we are executing from a schedule point of view, executing from cost point of view, of course, from safety and quality. Executing is the most important things for us to make sure that we meet the schedule in all the parameters.
So make a plan, a goal, and then execute to that, yes. And then all the learnings from that apply to the next one.
Exactly.
Not only to the next one, but also to the other fabs.
To the others, yes. And I can tell you that what I learned from the years is that the people doing it. The
yes.
people are the most important things for us. If you invest in the people, in managers, in technicians, in engineers, then you have an amazing team that can establish the plan and execute and learn and measure against the plan and fix and solve problem and receive decision in a real time. All of this make us a great team, and this is all about the people.
It's all the people, yeah. The people makes a great team. And like we were chatting a little bit earlier before the interview, we were talking about this is where dreams come true.
So I gave you an example from what happened at Intel. Like we have the design and process development and manufacturing. It's like the theoretical physics meet the applied physics, and then together they're making the physics of the world. That's what happened here.
No, that's great. That's just magic right there. We love
that
it.
That is the magic. That is the magic.
So here in Israel, there's a lot of design going on for Raptor Lake. How is this also tie a little bit into the manufacturing? Can you tell us a little bit more on that relationship?
Yes, we're in a close relationship with the Haifa, the design team. They are working with us, and they're working with, of course, with TD development in Portland. So they design the product. The TD team in Portland developed the process, and we are executing from a manufacturing point of view. So once we have the design, we have the development process, then we're executing. Now it's very interesting, the execution, because my friends here, Karen, Oren, and Merav, they received the new product request, and they need to introduce it into the line so tight and so accurate. So at the end of the line, it will yield.
Yeah.
It will yield with healthy microprocessor from electrical point of view, from yield point of view, and all the parameters will meet the customer demand. So that's what they are doing here. And they're running it so fast, so accurate, within a well-controlled tight limits. And then at the end, they brought this, I would say, new baby into the world.
It's definitely a new baby into the world that you guys should be really proud about it, and we can't yes. wait to hear more about it. Can you tell us the story that you have here of the people that you're helping, the 150 people that you started helping? I think that's a great story that we should share.
Yes, thank you very much. 3 years ago, I decided that we need to bring the soul into this city and to the factory. And you know, until then, we received the people that are the best engineers in the country, the best practical engineers. And I decided 3 years ago that south of Israel, they deserve something else, especially with the low socioeconomic population, that I want to contribute something from Intel to this community. And I decided to hire about 150 people without any education. And at the beginning, it was not easy. The people around here in the cities of Kiryat Gat, Sderot, Kiryat Malachi, south of Israel, they did not believe that Intel is open the gates for those kind of peoples and population. So we brought some of them into the fab, into the factory, to here to Kiryat Gat, to the campus. We showed them the what we are doing, like the dream.
Yeah, the dream job for
the magic, yes.
Yeah, the magic.
Yes, and we met with them. We helped them to write even the CV. We helped them to prepare to the interview, and we received about 150 people from them.
Wow.
It's a lot. And I can tell you that over the years, what we learned is that this is one of the most beautiful projects that we ever done for the community. Those 150 people now, some of them finishing, the 12 years exam. Some of them started practical engineers. Some of them started engineer school. And those people became, our best of people at Intel. It's a domino effect. It's impact the spouse. It's impact the kids that started to study now. It's impact the friends that they want to come and work for Intel. So this is one of the kind of project that bring you the soul into the factories and to the community. And it's like handshaking. Together we can make it.
Yes, no, that's great. which it goes back to the point that you said earlier, which is the magic is the people.
The magic is the people.
Yeah. Danny, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you for having time with us. Being here in Israel, it's been great. Thank you.
Thank you for coming. I appreciate it a lot.